The area which is below the demand function and above the equilibrium price is your consumer surplus. Now, how does this consumer surplus arise? Well, demand function is really measuring the willingness to pay of a consumer. So if a consumer is willing to pay this price, say 250, but he only has to pay $200, which is the market price, then this difference between what the maximum he's willing to pay and the market price is the consumer surplus. So that's true for the whole demand function, which lies above the market price. Now, the producer surplus is the area below the equilibrium price and above the supply function. The supply function is measuring the minimum cost of producing the good, or minimum price at which the supplier is willing to supply the good. Now, if at this point he's willing to supply the good at, say, 151, but he actually gets a price of $200 in the market. So this extra surplus that he gets is the producer surplus. What happens when you impose a tax on the supplier is that now when the producers think about the price at which they're willing to supply the good at, they are going to include the taxes that have been imposed on them, right? So if a $20 tax has been imposed on the supplier, then he would be willing to sell, let's assume we are at this point. Initially, he was willing to sell this good at 190, but now because he has to pay a $20 taxes in taxes, he is going to be supplying this amount of good at 190, which is the cost of producing the good, plus $20, which he has to pay in taxes. So he's willing to supply the good at 210. So what happens is that the supply function moves up by the amount of $20. Now, what is the market equilibrium price now that the taxes have been imposed? It is where the demand function and the supply plus tax function intersect. So the market price here is $210. Right? So this is what the consumer is paying for the good. So what is the consumer surplus? Well, it's the area under the demand function above the market price. This region, this green region, is consumer surplus. As you can see, the consumer surplus has now diminished. The market output has also gone down. There used to be 5,000 MP3 players in the market. Now there are 4,000 MP3 players in the market at this equilibrium price. Now what's happening to the producer surplus? Well, at this output, the cost of producing the good is 190, all right? So what is the price that the producers are getting? Well, they get 210, but they have to pay $20 out of this 210. So they're finally getting $190. So the producer surplus is the area above the supply function below 190. I repeat, the market price is 210. So producers get 210, but they have to pay a $20 tax to the government. So it's 210 minus $20, 190. This is the price the producers get. So the producer surplus is the area above the supply function below the amount that they're receiving, which is $190. Now, what is the tax revenue? Well, the tax revenue, so for each unit that is sold, the taxes paid are $20. So it's $20 multiplied by the amount of goods that are sold, which is 4,000. So it actually ends up being the height multiplied by the length, which is nothing but the area of this rectangle, which is the tax revenue. And in this case, it's $20 multiplied by 4,000 of MP3 players. So 4 into 20 would be your tax revenue. Now, this little triangle that we see is the amount that goes to no one. It is lost, and this is called the deadweight loss. Remember, before the taxes were imposed, the consumer surplus was this whole triangle area. Yeah, but now it has been diminished to this small triangle area. And this amount goes to the tax revenue to the government. But what happens to this small triangle? Well, that is your deadweight loss from the consumption side. And this small triangle is a deadweight loss from the production side. So this complete larger triangle area is your deadweight loss. Right? The deadweight loss is arising because look at this amount of output. There's underproduction of the goods, in this case, the MP3 player. There's underproduction of this good. This underproduction, this level of output, the demand is above the supply function. The value that was attached to this much of output was higher than the cost of producing the good, or the social the marginal benefit of this good is higher in this region than the cost of producing the good. So this is your deadweight loss, which accrues to no one but disappears because of underproduction of this good.